What happens when you turn a professional software engineer loose on the Internet of Things and home automation? Let's find out today on Smith House. Howdy, y'all. It's Jordan Smith. I'm over here at my buddy's house, and he's got a great home out here in Austin. He's got solar generation on the roof. He's got the power wall too here, and I'm actually over here to look at how he automated his dehumidifier into the bigger system. But as I was looking at the dehumidifier, I'm starting to see this home automation stuff, and I was like, what is that? And what is that? And what are you doing there? It was so cool. So this is a whole different video, not about dehumidification. I'm doing that too. But this one is specifically on how he did his home automation, and it's super slick. If you know anything about home automation, you know more than me. I have for years been a proponent of a dumb home. I still am. I don't think you should be putting things in the walls necessarily, or like a big iPad mounted into the wall, or even structured wiring. I'm getting less of a proponent of, because just the technology is changing so fast and so rapidly. Burying something in a wall usually just ends up being pulled out years later. I've done a lot of remodels where whatever the latest home automation from the 90s was is just completely obsolete and not useful at all. And so they just abandon it, and then we come in and we remove it all. Everything's Wi-Fi now. I'm still, for you IT people out there, you can comment below on, well, you shouldn't use structured wiring when. I'm all ears. Like, I'm not saying that absolutely no data wiring is necessary, but I just don't like the idea of signing up on to a technology that will be quickly replaced in the future, and it's all built in your home. So from my standpoint, I build beautiful, functional, resilient, and healthy homes. And then all the technology stuff I like to put on top of that. And this is what my buddy has done. So he uses Home Assist, and it is a third-party open source software. So you get a Raspberry Pi, you get a mini SD card, you go online, you download the hard drive onto the SD card, you put it back in the Raspberry Pi, and then that's your Home Assist. And it connects via Wi-Fi to a controller, and then you do all kinds of things. He's got stuff where it's looking at how much power he's pulling in from the grid. He's looking at how much power is being generated from the solar roof and is being put into the power wall here. He's looking at how much power he's using in his dehumidifier, his ACs, all of that stuff he's being able to look at. And then on top of that, he's able to automate the lights, he's able to automate the shades, he's able to automate absolutely everything. And I want to run you quickly through his version of doing this. Maybe you find some inspiration from it. Maybe you're smart enough to figure out all of this. He says it's not very hard. I don't know. Maybe you have a software that you like better, that's easier. Comment below whatever your thoughts are, but I want to run you through what he has done here. So first of all, we've got this dashboard here, and this dashboard gives us everything. It gives us what our HVAC's doing, what our dehumidifier's doing, what our lights are doing, the front porch, all of that stuff, what the weather is, what the humidity is, everything from a quick dashboard. If we go down into the next level, we can look at energy usage, and I love this graph here. It actually shows how much power the solar wall is, or the solar roof is generating, how much is going to the grid, how much is going to the battery, how much is going to the house, how much is going from the battery to the house. We can see all of that chasing these little dots. The faster the dots go, the more power is going through there. You also get these graphs of a day-to-day graph on what your solar looks like, on what your usage looks like. You see all your sources, and then you also get to see individual devices. He does have a Tesla car that gets plugged in here to the garage, and you'll see that kick on at night and charge and pull that power from the battery and then from the grid as well. There's a lot of other things in here, but the one that I wanted to show you was this automation here. So once you get into the automation, you can just do whatever you want. You set all of these scenes. So he's got the automation for his dehumidifier. What got us started on this whole conversation was like, if the grid goes down, I want to go into power saving mode. So I'm going to turn off the dehumidifier. I'm going to turn off my lights. I'm going to do all of this stuff to conserve battery capacity. So we're only going to send power to those critical units, and things like the dehumidifier, which is more for comfort and health, we're going to let that shut off. And I was like, oh, that's super cool. Then he's got other things. He's like, hey, I want to look at with the ventilation on the dehumidifier. I want to see what the temperature is outside and what the humidity is from outside, because even though I've got it calling for ventilation for 15 minutes out of every hour, I may not want to do that if the heat and the humidity outside is beyond a certain part. And he's able to do all of that wirelessly, connecting from the Ecobee thermostat through Home Assistant up to some Shelly relays. So it's completely wireless. Like he doesn't have something wired from the thermostat to the dehumidifier. He's able to do that all wirelessly and turn that dehumidifier on, which is super, super cool. Hey, thanks so much for watching. I hope this got your gears turning. It's actually changed my mind quite a bit on what is available with home automation. Like I said at the top, I've been really pushing against it, and I still stand through most of that is gimmicky, but this is one of the few integrations where, I mean, of course the guy's a software engineer, so it just works. Like everything is super clear, super easy to understand. You go right to where you're needing to get your information and you see that information. And then if things happen, like the grid goes down, your whole house can change to maximize how far the Tesla battery, the power wall can get. Thanks so much for watching. Comment below what's your favorite home automation software and what are you using it for? Are you connecting it to your power supplies as well? Like the video if you liked it. Subscribe if we've earned it. Go check us out over at smithhouseco.com. If you want consulting, you can go schedule it over there. And we'll see you next time on Smith House.